Welcome back to another very exciting tutorial here at the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. My name is Jesus Ramirez, and you can find me on Instagram at JRFromPTC. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to work better and faster with the Content Aware Fill. Content Aware Fill seamlessly fills the selection with similar image content nearby. So what that means is that we can make a selection and fill to auto-generate pixels based on the content around it. So if we wanted to remove this bus, we can come into the lasso tool and make a loose selection around the bus. We don't have to be very precise. Actually, for better results, it's better if you create a selection that extends slightly into the area you want to replicate. So it's okay that we're getting some of the street here. And now that I've made my selection, I'm going to bring up the fill window. You can go into edit and fill. This brings up the fill dialog box. Make sure that under contents, you have content aware. By default, you should have color adaptation check. If it's not, then just click on this box to enable it. Color adaptation algorithmically blends the color of the fill with the surrounding color. In other words, having this checkbox enabled makes sure that what blends in matches the original surrounding areas. Then press OK. And you'll notice that Photoshop did a great job analyzing the contents of the selection and figuring out what the photo would have looked like if the bus hadn't been there. I'm going to go into select, deselect, so we can remove our selection. And you can do the same thing with this car if you like. I'm just going to make a quick selection, and I'm going to go a little bit faster this time. This time I'm going to use a keyboard shortcut for the fill command. So I'm going to hold shift and backspace, that's shift delete on the Mac. And I'm going to press OK, and Photoshop will remove the car. Again, it did a great job, but sometimes there are complicated areas that don't give us good results. I'm going to deselect by using a keyboard shortcut as well. Control D, Command D to deselect. And now I'm going to zoom in into this van. As great as Content Aware Fill is, it doesn't always do a great job in complicated areas. Let me show you what I mean by that. I'm going to select the lasso tool once again, and I'm going to select this van, including that speed bump, and I'm drawing a very rough selection. But that's okay, it's not that important to get a very accurate selection for what I'm about to show you. And actually, I'll get these areas as well, because the content won't really match. And I'm going to zoom in, just to go in between these light posts. I'm holding shift to add to the selection. And I'm going to hold alt to subtract from the selection. And that should be good enough. At least for this example. I'm going to double tap on the hand tool so that we could fit the image to screen. I'm going to hold shift and backspace to bring up the fill dialog box, and then I'm going to press OK. And Photoshop doesn't do that good of a job. Notice that we got some of those trees, part of the lamppost, and a lot of different elements that are really not part of the street that we're trying to fill in. But don't worry, there's an advanced way that we can work with Content Aware Fill. I'm going to press Control Alt Z, Command Option Z on the Mac to undo. And before I do anything else, I'm going to save this selection. So I'm going to go into Select, Save Selection, and I'm just going to call this selection Van and press OK. And I'm doing this to save a little bit of time. I don't want to have to redraw that selection. And the way we're going to fix this problem is by telling Photoshop what pixels to analyze. So I'm going to grab the lasso tool, I'm going to hold Shift, and I'm going to add more pixels that I want Photoshop to analyze. So essentially the rest of this road. So I have this road here, and maybe I'll grab some of the pixels on this side as well, because the road is very similar and it could analyze those pixels, and maybe these as well. And I think that'll be good enough. Then I'm gonna click on the layer mask icon to create a layer mask. And these are all the pixels that Photoshop has to work with now. Then I'm gonna load the selection, select, load selection, and we're going to select the van selection that we saved a moment ago. And I'm going to go into the layer, not the layer mask. Make sure that the focus, the white outline, is on the layer, and hold shift and backspace, shift delete on the Mac to bring up the fill dialog box. Under contents, we have content aware, color adaptation is checked, and we're going to press OK. And now Photoshop is going to fill in that area using only the pixels that we told it to analyze. So essentially what's in the layer mask. So I'm going to delete the layer mask and then press Control D, Command D to deselect. And now we have a much better fill. We of course have some details that we need to go in there and adjust, but the overall fill was much better. One last thing I want to say about Content Aware Fill is that Content Aware randomly synthesizes similar image content. If you don't like your original result, you can undo and apply Content Aware Fill once again, and you'll get a different result. And I'll show you what I mean by that. If I just want to remove this area here, I can go into Shift, Backspace, press OK, and I'll do that once more. Notice that the pixels look different every single time I press OK. So the algorithm applies a random effect so you can continue filling with Content Aware until you get something that you like. And keep in mind that Content Aware Fill is great for repairing larger, more complex areas. And that's it for this tutorial. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to click on that like button and share it with a friend. If you're new to the Photoshop Training Channel, then click on that subscribe button. Thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.